guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Dolly, and this is my third video about coronavirus. First, I want to say that all the numbers I mentioned in this video is only valid for today, or to be specific, it's only valid for this moment because infections and cases are changing all the time. And I will share what I feel in Shanghai and what I see from our local news. Today is January 29th, 2020. 6,002 cases are confirmed and 132 people died. Now, most international airlines support free refund and change for China-related flights such as Lufthansa, SAS, Canada Airlines. Vietnam closed road entrance for China, and Sri Lanka cancelled arrival visa for Chinese citizens. Hong Kong stopped cross-region bus and trains and reduced flight numbers. Hong Kong also stopped issuing entrance permission for 49 cities' Chinese citizens. Since I work in Sweden, I pay more attention to Scandinavia regions. Denmark, Finland, and Sweden airports don't set any extra controls for Chinese passengers. But Finland government said, due to coronavirus, tourists from China decreased dramatically, and Finn Airlines cancelled several flights to and from Beijing and Nanjing. Norway and Iceland are anyway too expensive for Chinese travelers, and I didn't see any related news. On January 28, midnight, there was a Chinese flight, HO1340, flying from Osaka, Japan to Shanghai, China. But since there were 16 Wuhan citizens in the flight, some Shanghai passengers refused them to be on board. What's more, some Wuhan passengers had fever, but they took some pills and tried to escape from health check. I know that we should be more generous and show more sympathy to our fellows, but it doesn't mean that people can lie and hide the fact. So in the end, the Chinese airline, Junyao Airlines, decided to change the destination from Shanghai to Wuhan and brought 95 Wuhan and Hubei passengers back to their home city. 19 boxes of masks and protection clothes were carried together with passengers back to Wuhan. All the rest passengers will take other flight back to Shanghai. Virus is spreading very fast and it has 14 days incubation period. So some people may take flights before 23 or 22, and now they are confirmed that they are infected. Our transportation department publish news every day and inform people which train and seat that specific patient took. Till now, I saw at least 50 different flights and trains information. But I'm wondering, since everyone needs to scan an ID card to take the flight or train, why can't related department message or email these passengers directly? I heard that in Japan and UK, all suspected and confirmed cases don't need to pay for the medical treatment. In 2003, China covered all SARS patients' medical treatment, but this time it depends on cities. I didn't find a specific policy for Shanghai, but for national-wise, our medical insurance will cover part of it, only if you have a job in China or you worked in China before, or you are retired or you are under 18 years old. Then the patient needs to pay for the rest. After the patient is recovered, the local government will give a certain amount compensation. I didn't find the particular ratio for each part, but hope all patients will get the medical treatment fairly and efficiently. I went to buy masks and alcohol yesterday afternoon, and I cycled around, checked 8 pharmacies. Both were sold out. Although all masks factories have already speeded up to cover shortage, it's still difficult to get masks in Shanghai. In the end, I only found a small bottle of alcohol cotton ball in the pharmacy, which is 5 km away from my home. Luckily, it's not overpriced and cost 2 euros. In the end, I want to say that I refuse all the heartless and unrespectful comments like, "You Chinese, you deserve it," or "You eat dogs," or "It's a revenge or punishment from nature." If you ask a Chinese, "Do you eat dogs?" I believe 99.99% people don't. I have a dog and a rabbit. so I completely agree that it's wrong to eat wild animals or dogs. But still, a lot of countries eat wild animals. I don't want to judge these things. But one thing for sure is that we are suffering now, and we shouldn't let the majority of people sacrifice for the extremely minor people's mistake. It's not only a challenge for Chinese, but for the whole world. Maybe coronavirus will mainly be spread in China and it won't bother your daily life, but it will affect economy, business, international trade, tourism, medical, education, culture, art, sports, all these aspects to most countries more or less. Hope China stays strong, hope our government will control the disease efficiently, and all our medical staff are safe. I will keep you guys updated. Bye!